have fear of any contradiction, is there will be no repeat of what happened in this match, which I think is still one of the great rugby statistics of all time. When Wales played Scotland in 1963, there were 111 lineouts in that match. That will not happen this afternoon. But blue skies we have, and we have the pyrotechnics, and we weren't expecting this, and actually, the wind seems to be abating as well, so maybe like the match against Ireland 3 weeks or so ago, when conditions actually gave us the opportunity for a fantastic match, maybe we'll get a repeat of that this afternoon. And it is worth saying that by half-time in Dublin later on today, we'll have reached the halfway point in this year's championship, and by then, one of these two sides will still be in contention, while the other will have been blown off course for yet another season. So, after two captivating and compelling weekends, what does this third instalment of this year's Six Nations have in store for us? The teams are lining up, as you can see. Invidious to ask Andy and Jonathan what they think is going to happen. Keith, you have the verdict.
In many respects, I kind of like to see Scotland win. I'm married to a Scottish woman. I think it makes it easier at home. But I think Wales by a couple of points.
Martin Williams, Chris Patterson and Eddie Butler follow the anthems.
Good afternoon from Murrayfield. John Barclay leads Scotland for the first time from the start of a game. A new captain, a new spirit alive here at Murrayfield. Prop Gordon Reid says this pack has to stand up today. Nobody will make more tackles than the Grey Brothers. Nobody will know more about Wales than captain John Barclay of the Scarlets. Stuart Hogg has scored in the last four Six Nations games. Alex Dunbar has the same number of turnovers. No Greg Laidlaw. Can Finn Russell kick his goals? It's the same Wales pack that started against England. The outstanding Ross Moriarty at number 8. Jake Ball, the ball carrier, in the second row. And the same three quarters except for George North back on the wing. Tries in the last 5-6 Nations games for North. 6 would be a Six Nations record. Ross Ford has more caps, 104, than the rest of the Scottish bench put together. Luke Chartres, Taulupe Faletau and JB Roberts have 221 caps between them. Today's referee is John Lacey of Ireland. The ball has been delivered by the Royal Marines, who abseiled off the West Stand. Special delivery of the match ball. Scotland in their huddle. Can they keep the spirit born of victory over Ireland in round one against Wales? Both sides played 2, won 1, lost 1. If they are going to have a tilt at the title, they need to win here today. Finn Russell starts Scotland at home against Wales. Jonathan Davis catches for Wales on the edge of his own 22. Ken Owens, the hooker.
6 away now.
Dan Bigger.
Stay, Red. No.
Penalty against Scotland. Offside. Referee John Lacey and good afternoon, Chris Patterson.
Good afternoon, Eddie Butter. Looking forward to this one. It was a well-taken kick-off by Jonathan Davis, wasn't it? Wales looked very comfortable with that kick away. Scotland straying offside. Interesting to see the first tackle of the day was made by John Hardy, fully recovered from his bump in Paris. It was a big collision with Ken Owens.
Dan Bigger will be keeping an eye on the flags high over the stadium. The wind was due to drop, and it has. It is behind Wales in this first half. Bigger takes it flat, makes a yard against John Hardy, up over the halfway line. Now then, Scotland, their first set piece, they will have the put in.
Finn Russell got up well on the line and made the tackle. Dan Bigger, yeah, Dan Bigger's big. Martin, you'll know him very well for a 10. He almost rode the tackle, but the line speed and the pressure was there. And the fumble at the breakdown. Gigi Tipperick.
Very, very physical. I think it was that man, Fraser Brown, in there causing a mess. And sloppy lineup from Wales. They won it, but it was poor distribution to Reece Webb. And that had a knock-on effect. Fascinating battle between the flankers today. More or less got 4 open side flankers today, so that tackle area, contact area is going to be key.
Nice and slow now, boys. Crouch. Bind. Set. Stay.
Scotland have given away more penalties at the scrum than any other country.
Boys, I need you both working harder here now.
Seconds!
Crouch!
Sick!
Ali Price, who came on
bind
early in Paris for Greg Laidlaw. Penalty to Scotland.
Yeah, I think they've given all their penalties away, Scotland, 8, I think, and so far in the tournament, on opposition ball, on their own ball. You know, they haven't been stable, but they haven't given penalties away, so that's a fantastic start for them. I thought Stuart Hogg might have a crack there, Chris.
Yeah, it's, you can see John Lacey's jersey flapping vigorously in the wind. The wind does swirl here at BT Murrayfield. As you can see, has it affected Finn Russell's kick? It actually, no, it hasn't. It's a good kick, and it's a good start in Scotland, but it was Robbie Evans, I think, with his head and shoulders. This is getting reiterated too by John Lacey, but below it drove him into the ground under pressure from Xander Ferguson.
Fraser Brown with an attacking Scotland line out to aim at.
One stop,
Richie Gray sets up the driving maul. Ali Price goes
use it.
Digging for it, is told to use it. Price. The door closed on him quickly. Ken Owens with the tackle. Johnny Gray. Good clearing out by the Scottish forwards. They've committed a lot of forwards to the ruck, but there is the ball on the edge of the Wales 22. Back out of the 22. Wales try counter-rucking, but it's still there for Scotland. Johnny Gray again. Finn Russell. Stuart Hogg waits outside John Hardy. Hugh Jones on the burst. Good passing out of contact by Scotland. Stuart Hogg to the ground. Number 8, Ryan Wilson drives it up. Richie Gray, tackled by Alan Wynne-Jones, among others. Penalty advantage being played for Scotland. Russell. Again, it's a good tackle by Ken Owens, but back to the original penalty.
Well, that's a good start and attack by Scotland. A physical defensive line from Wales. They are very tight, Martin. And Scotland didn't go wide until they got some momentum. I think it was Johnny Gray who got over the advantage line, and then Finn Russell set Hugh Jones wide, out wide. He set him away, but then there's a clear directional play by Scotland. It's forward fast before they go wide, isn't it?
Yeah, as expected, you know, it's very physical, but you saw earlier on in that passage there, Dan Biggar goes for the strip of the ball, which he does so well, but when you miss the man, which I think he does on this occasion, Hugh Jones, you know, he's through.
Matthew?
It was good off-road by Hardy, and this is Biggar. He goes for the strip, misses it.
Yeah, can you hear me?
You've got to get the man on the ground early. It's a good start, great start from Scotland.
Yeah, thank you. Great, thank you.
Finn Russell, simple kick, but well, he had one of these in Paris. It was a conversion. This, Scotland's first penalty. And it's over, and that will make Finn Russell feel very good.
There's a good reward from good pressure from Scotland early on. I'd pick you up on that, Eddie. I don't think there are any simple kicks in an international game, but he did well to keep his composure and chip Scotland in an early lead.
You would know, Chris, you have been out there in that horribly exposed position of being the kicker.
That's why you practice.
Someone who missed one right in front of the post, I know his pain.
Here is Russell. And here is his opposite number, Dan Biggar.
Afito!
Jake Ball, who did a lot of the heavy work against England, had a good game, the Scarlet second row. Alan Wynne-Jones in midfield. Tackling is ferocious. Scott Williams. Reece Webb wearing the little head bandage.
Six away! Rock four and five!
There for Webb. Bigger to Ball again. Good hands, Ken Owens. Ross Moriarty. First glimpse of the Gloucester back row forward. Rob Evans took it well. Scott Williams again. Lee Halfpenny. The ball comes out to Liam Williams.
Ball there now.
Jake Ball.
It's five. Stay there, five.
The turnover is good, says the referee. Scotland steal the ball. Jake Ball slow to get back into position.
No, play on.
Heavy duty carrying. Xander Fagerson. Ali Price takes responsibility for the clearance. Lee Halfpenny, it's short, it goes out, tries to clear a line out back, but that's good clearance work by Scotland.
It's a physical start to the game, isn't it? Look at some of these collisions. Not a lot of footwork at the moment from the attack of the ball carrier. There's Gordon Reid's turnover drive and Alan Wynne-Jones off the ball. And then from there, Scotland played two phases. And it was really important that Ali Price's kick found touch.
One of those little victories. Good work by Gordon Reid at the counter up. Penalty to Wales, being taken out in the air.
Yeah, they used Tipperick and Wolverton a lot in the line-out, Wales. I think over 17 times in the first couple of games. And Tipperick just pulled in the air, you know, you've got to let the man catch the ball, come to the ground.
Danbigger looking to get as far into the 22 as he can.
Why would Wales do that, Martin? Use two back row guys in the line-out so often.
They've just done a lot over the last two games. It's been a success. They're very, very good line-out players, very easy to lift. I think that's the reason why. You could be exposed in wide areas, but so far in the Six Nations, the backs have done their job behind.
Justin Tipperick is the dummy jumper that time. Alan Wynne-Jones in the middle of the lineup. Wales try to set up the drive. Tipperick sets it up. Warburton continues the move. Penalty advantage to Wales. It's a knock-on advantage. Reece Webb, 10 metres short of the line. There is the prize. Jake Ball.
Advantage off feet.
Sam Warburton over the ball, protects it. It's gone loose. Liam Williams has to go back to gather. No advantage. Penalty to Wales.
There was two penalties in the build-up there. The second one slightly closer to the Scotland line as Reece Webb is looking to keep the Scottish defence on us. The Scottish defender off the feet. The first one's for offside and Reece Webb took a half gap there and burst through, didn't he, man?
He's so dangerous, Reece Webb. It's his trademark. You know it's coming as a forward, but it's so difficult to defend. He's so explosive, so powerful off the mark. He just gives that little look, the eyes, and he's gone. Gordon Reid has bought that. Can't move. If you're Gordon Reid, that's your man, Reece Webb. You've got to stick to him until that ball is gone.
Okay, no problem. No problem.
Gareth Davis is similar on the bench as well, isn't he? Both really quite cute attackers in around the breakdown.
We'll deal with that as best we can.
Lee Halfpenny. Slightly longer. But that's only the 22.
Is this one easier then?
Square at Murrayfield. The penalty by Lee Halfpenny off Toulon. Three apiece. Rob Howley in the suit. Sean Edwards in front of him. High kick. Liam Williams waits. Stuart Hogg. Doesn't take the quick one. Scotland will take their time.
Yeah, that's a good kick by Liam Williams, wasn't it? And the swirling wind up this West Ham side, that the ball just swirled, but it's good length, cleared almost up to the Scotland 10-metre line. That's exactly what you're looking for after you've scored points, is clear your danger there.
Fraser Brown again. John Barkley. This time, Wales take the jumper out in the air.
Yeah, you can't help yourself sometimes. You're competing for the ball. Jake Ball that time, he's gone for it. Sometimes as well as the guy's lifting the man, that perhaps doesn't support the man as well as he should, and it's an easy penalty for Scotland.
It's a scruffy one. So, penalty advantage not taken by Scotland. It's a 22 dropout for Wales.
No,
a lot of penalties, isn't it, in the first 12 minutes. Six penalties in the first 13 minutes. Hasn't really got any momentum in the game yet. It's killed. It's very stop-start.
Finn Russell. Well, this time it's Wales taking their time. Dan Bigger goes back. He's going to belt this downfield, downwind. Russell. Inside. Ryan Wilson, the number eight. Good charge by Wilson. Scotland on the move. Johnny Gray makes ground in the Welsh half now.
Hold here now.
Fraser Brown.
Hold.
Russell. Out. Barkley out in the three quarters. Wales trying to hold him up.
Tackle now.
Ball is available there.
Johnny Gray to Gordon Reid. Richie Gray just scrambles an extra yard. Ali Price.
Apparently take 11.
Tim Visser gives away the penalty. And you can hear what the crowd thinks of that.
I'll ask Martin what he thinks, but I think Tim Visser is a penalty for taking the man out there. I think it's a missed timing when he gets up. As the ball's caught in that swirling wind, and I think it's a fair competition for the ball, just gets his timing wrong.
No, I agree, it looks in real time, it looked like a fair contest from Visser. Yes, he's gone up early, but...
I think the fact that Ali Price had to kick, as you see, the incident again, it's a harsh penalty.
Bigger's done well there, he's milked that for all night. That's not a penalty in my book. I think Visser's got up before him, he's gone up early. Bigger's thrown his arms and legs, he's bought it.
Alwyn Jones, well picked up by both scrum half and by Scott Williams in the centre. Justin Titherick tries to tidy up. It's still there for Wales, but they're having to fight hard for possession. Bigger.
Stop, no red, stop two.
Slow possession, so up it goes towards Stuart Hogg. Outside the 22, Jonathan Davis with the follow-up tackle. George North over the ball. Scotland back in good numbers. Johnny Gray.
Counter, counter. Use a nine.
Scrum half Price. To Lee Halfpenny. Well taken by Halfpenny.
Six half now.
Under pressure from Tommy Boyd. Ball. Distribution from the second row. Ross Moriarty gets up, has a second drive.
All available.
Bigger. Scott Williams. George North. Well marshalled by Visser. Rob Evans. Bigger. Flat. Wales trying the passing game out of contact. They've surrendered possession to Scotland. And Finn Russell spots ground behind Lee Halfpenny. Halfpenny goes back and watches it go over for a 22 dropout.
Now Lee Halfpenny having all, as I said, a little bit of action off the ball. Finn Russell getting himself involved with Lee Halfpenny.
What is it with you Scottish halfbacks?
They're born angry. A Scottish halfback's born angry, but John Lacey's going to carry it down.
If he interferes, I'll deal with it. You've got your penalty over there now. Yes, thank you. That's enough now. Time on.
Never short of a word or two, Dan Bigger. But I tell you what, some of these hits in midfield. John Hardy put one on Scott Williams. There's no quarter asked at the minute. This is full on.
Tackle's good.
Good tackle by Ken Owens on Ryan Wilson.
Passes flat.
Different one. Works though. Scotland into the Welsh half.
Strip is backwards, so play on.
Davis.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
Wales claim the turnover and they earn the penalty.
Six on his feet from the start and arriving.
Yeah, it's a textbook Sam Overton. He's sniffed that. He's just run behind the contact area, behind the tackle area, and he's seen a little glimpse of light and he's gone in and won a fantastic turnover for Wales.
What's incredible at Sam Warburton is the speed that he identifies it and then actually accelerates into the breakdown to make sure he takes the contact on his own turn with his hands.
If you see a replay, there's a height as well, his body height, and once he's over that ball, you've got no chance. Just catching the end of it there, but if you saw a bigger picture, where he came from, the speed and the height.
It's a break from Warburton, and it's just forcing the pass. A little bit from Dan Bigger trying to give that one extra pass. Good invention. It ended in turnover.
Alouin Jones wins the line-out. Away comes Moriarty. Rhys Webb. Liam Williams, well read by Finn Russell. Webb. Support from Tipperick. Webb doesn't need him for the moment. It's another turnover by Scotland.
Stay three.
They're virtually playing with 40 men at the minute, Scotland as well. John Hardy's in a real bad shape.
Russell.
Ali Price. It's a pattern. If it's slow ball, Price is happy to put a boot to it. Good wriggling by Lee Halfpenny out of the tackle.
Ball is out.
Scotland again. Work themselves into a turnover situation.
Well, there certainly are a few turnovers. There's so much competition in and around the breakdown on the ball. Kicks are being put under pressure. This is a wonderful take. First of all, by Lee Halfpenny in the spin at the tackle. He fights to stay in the field. He knows he's isolated. He buys a little bit of time and space for himself. Class player, Lee Halfpenny, did really well. But the one thing I think that will frustrate the Scottish defence is the number of times that the line's been broken in and around that breakdown. Rhys Webb's already had two breaks in there. Robbie Evans has been in and around there as well. The first place you want to shore up is close to the contact and been broken there once or twice.
Is it not the case that John Hardy was sort of brought in to shore up that area of play? But if he's injured now, it'll compromise them there.
Well, yeah, I think after the big hit on Scott Williams, he's really struggling. I think it's a knee or his leg, he's really struggling. So, you know, at this level, you can't. If you're carrying an injury, you just found out so easily.
Yeah, he hurt. It was his right knee, I think. But and Hamish Watson, they've got one of the, for me, the players of the tournament so far, ready to come off the bench. Very similar player to John Hardy. John Hardy's as tough as they come, but he is struggling. It looks like he's carrying his right knee. You just see him there. But Hamish Watson has already made a replacement. He'll come on and make a big impact if needed.
John Hardy at the back of the line, and he's walking very awkwardly. Gordon Reid also having treatment. He looks all right.
Up
she goes from Price again.
Yeah.
This time it comes back, but into touch.
You can see the kick employs as well, Martin. Everything's contestable, whether it's off 9 or 10. Bigger and Finn Russell have had high ones as well. They're looking to kick to win the possession back, both sides.
Wales reduce the numbers in the line-out. Sam Warburton goes out into the three quarters. Alan Wynne-Jones wins.
One stop line.
Rhys Webb comes into view. Takes his time. Just a new variation from Wales to try and push Scotland back a little bit. Webb's kick. Tim Vissert waits and catches under pressure from George North, who holds him up.
Two pretty big wingers over there against each other, Chris, isn't it?
Yeah. I'm safer sitting here, right?
And it's good work by George North, because Wales will have the put-in.
That's just raw strength from George North. Tim Visser is a big man, he's a strong, powerful winger. The kick was a little bit too long, as we see John Hardy in the background still picking up some team. The kick was a little bit too long, gave Tim Visser time to catch, but then watch this. The initial contact's okay, and then George North gets his feet underneath him, lifts up Tim Visser. Holds up with the help of Bigger. I think Moriarty's in there and wins the turnover.
It's good so far.
You can can see the call as well. Bigger, it's Rob Evans, sorry, who's in there helping out.
So just looking.
The players want to work together. They don't want to bring Tim Vincent to the ground. They want to hold him up.
Just looking at John Hardy arriving there, he could hardly add any weight to the driving situation. He's down again.
Yeah, like Chris said, you know, they've got a ready-made replacement, Hamish Watson. So, you know, John Hardy was only probably going to play 60 minutes anyway, so they just strap him up, a few painkillers, and hang on in there for as long as he can go. But when you're up against Warburton and Tipperick, you know, you need to be 100%. There he is, Hamish Watson. As Chris said, he's been absolutely superb in those opening two rounds.
He adds an attacking edge as well. John Hardy's destructive. He's so tough, he's so hard. And then this is where Hardy picks up the knock. It was this one, it was a big tackle as well on Rob Evans. You see his right leg. It looks like obviously a contact injury, which is better than a strain or a twist. Could be a dead leg. There's his right knee, but he's certainly struggling. He's going on, he's going to take his place in the back row in this scrum, but Hamish Watson is ready to get his tracksuit off.
John Hardy on the side of the scrum. Free kick quickly taken by Rhys Webb. Scott Williams long to Lee Halfpenny. A chance for Wales and Liam Williams, first try of the game.
Well, Liam Williams scores. He's followed on from his performance against England. He's a man on fire. Five clean line breaks so far in the championship, and he's added another try. And this was all about the quick thinking of Rhys Webb and the execution of passing across the back line. Every ball out in front, and Liam Williams can finish it. Rhys Webb has already taken the quick tap. Watch the pass from Bigger and from Williams. And in this one, the timing and the accuracy from Lee Halfpenny, perfect for Williams, who scores in the left-hand corner.
Yeah, all about Rhys Webb, quick thinking, but really narrow in defence, Scotland. And like I say, those ball, perfect passing from the Welsh back line. And that's a great start, and it's the end of Hardy as well. He's walking off as we see the replay.
Corner cam taken out by Stuart Hogg. Liam Williams, the try scorer. Lee Halfpenny from wide out. And just behind him, here he is, John Hardy, will play no further part in the game. Hamish Watson is poised to come on. Will it curl in? Beautifully struck by Lee Halfpenny. Five becomes seven, and the Welsh lead grows. Scotland 3, Wales 10.
Just the speed of the quick tap, wasn't it? And then Scotland's defence doesn't have time to go organised from the free kick at the scrum. And it's a good start for Wales.
Finn Russell towards the try scorer, Liam Williams. He's off again.
Ball there now. Ball's off.
Ken Owens, the hooker, back in his 22.
Still in,
Dan Bigger
still in.
Takes up position straight behind Rhys Webb.
Inside.
Stuart Hogg catches inside to Russell, who reaches well and runs well and passes well, and the catch by Tommy Boyd is not made. Quickly taken, but no, they'll come back.
Option taken.
There's Tommy Seymour. This is a counter attack from Finn Russell as he tries to look for some space in the right hand side, but unfortunately knocked on by Tommy Seymour.
Down on the ground, Jason White.
Yeah, it's been fascinating to watch the battle of the second rows today. Richie and Johnny Gray for Scotland, huge involvement. It's going up against Alan Wynne, one of the best second rows in the world. With the bigger context, the summer tour to New Zealand, they'll all be vying to get on that stage. And how this battle plays out today will have a key bearing on the game.
The break by Rhys Webb, the pass to Liam Williams, the try scorer. Webb in support, Williams cuts back inside. Rob Evans in support, held off the ball. Will it go to a review? I think it will.
Rhys Webb, that man Rhys Webb again, but he is so cute. Dude. I don't think the referee will pick up on this, but as he's passed the ball, he's just pulled Seymour back.
We need to check the actions of Red 9 after he gives the pass.
Okay.
Well, he spotted it.
Potential foul play.
Potential foul play by Red Nine. It's not try yes on that.
Okay. Television match official, Rowan Kitch.
Got you, Johnny.
Potential foul play first. My view is knocked back by four blue. And then try yes or no.
Looking at the actions of Red Nine after he's made the pass first.
Yeah, as Reece Webb, the man who picks up, scintillating break, freeing Liam Williams up this left-hand side, but to the naked eye, looked as if he reached out a hand to pull back Tommy Seymour. We'll have a look here. So quick in his run, isn't he? The pass is good, and then we're looking at Reece Webb.
He's completely dictating the game, Webb, at the minute, isn't he? Very, very subtle, Paul.
It's that area again, isn't it? And then you can see there the pull on Tommy Seymour. Which Seymour have caught him? Who knows? But it's certainly impeded.
Okay, John, what's the angles?
Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that.
You're okay with the actions of
Is
Red Nine?
A clear pull for you, boy?
That's a pull for me back, and okay. It stops the player potentially making the tackle.
Okay. It's a pull back by nine.
What about Blue putting his arm up?
Pull back 15.
Alan Wynne-Jones has a counter argument, but the penalty against Reece Webb. It's given. Little shake of the head, but he knows.
Yeah, and the good old lady would have got away with that one. It was a clever piece of play from Webb. Just enough of a pull there, I think, to cause the penalty is so, so debatable.
A banana kick from Finn Russell, and Scotland, instead of facing a conversion, are now just outside the Welsh 22.
Now, here's the break. It's so sharp around that edge, isn't it? Great ball to the tailor lineup for Ken Owens. Alan Wynne-Jones makes a space right through the middle, and then look how sharp he knows where he's going. He's pointing to Liam Williams, he gets outside Gordon Reid, and I believe there is a reach there just with the left hand to Tommy Seymour, and the penalty was given.
Fraser Brown. Scotland.
One stop, one!
With great deliberation, set up the driving maul. Harry Price ordered to use it. That's Rob Evans scrapping away for the ball.
High tackle
given by against Sam Warburton. He wanted to get his arms around the ball carrier and hold him up. That's a good tackle by Dan Bigger, but it's still advantage Scotland. Finn Russell, that's a good pass to Stuart Hogg. Halfpenny goes back. Hogg in hot pursuit. Claimed the try, he has a little smile about it all. We go back to the penalty.
Yeah, I think it's Sam over in an alley price, isn't he? He's gone high.
High by six red.
Yeah.
Six.
Mm. So difficult, he's sniping round. He's obviously a bigger man, and high anywhere around that area now, you're going to get penalised.
Yeah, even if the initial contact's not there, this is where it ends from Turahawk's chip through. He was claiming a try, but how well has Lee Halfpenny done there under huge amount of pressure? Stuart Hogg, even to get himself on the end of that chip shows how quick he is, but I think he knows exactly what he was doing, Lee Halfpenny. Well, two competitors, Lee Halfpenny did really well there.
Finn Russell lines up the kick. Scotland celebrates. The gap is reduced to 4 points. Vern Cotter doesn't give much away, the big New Zealander, but his side are up to six, Wales 10. Into the Scotland 22. Hogg jumps for it. Thumped back in the second tackle. Johnny Gray. This is the new player on the field, Hamish Watson. he's done ever so well to stay in field there, because for a moment it looked as if he could only be pushed into touch. In fact, he is in touch.
Leave it, leave it.
I think you saw an example there of how physical the Welsh bats are. We saw when we go to the handbags.
Leave it.
There's a little bit of it's drama going on back there.
It's brilliant. The scrum half starts in, then he walks away. And he's, what's Reece Webb? He started, he's out of shot now, he's gone.
Where is the little imp? See, he's nowhere there. There, he's out of sight now.
Your line-out, Scott.
Yeah, just seeing the physicality of the Welsh backs. We saw George North holding Visa up earlier. Scott Williams that time. You know, it was a good carry by him, just watching, but it's the power. Here we go.
Counter-wrecking by Scotland. And again, they turned the ball over. Dan Digger tore up in the line, but Hamish Watson does well to turn out of the tackle. Russell, infield. Ali Bryce has to deal with slow ball. Gordon Reid, the prop. Sam Warburton trying to buy a penalty. John Lacey having none of it.
Use the line.
Slow for Price. Tim Visser takes it well. Finds Richie Gray in support. Russell. Scottish advantage. Wales have slowed it down and have earned themselves a penalty just when Scotland were building an overlap on one side.
Leave it down three.
They give a penalty in front of the posts quite a way out.
Well, it's the same two suspects at number six and number seven, Sam Warburton and Justin Tipperick, working really well together. Scotland actually had an overlap there. As you hear John Lacey, I haven't alerted with Alan Jones, the skipper, to see what the decision is. They are going to kick a goal. Warburton, Tipperick working so well together. Warburton with the tackle this time, and then watch the speed of Justin Tipperick from ground to feet. He gets up and he wins the space over the ball and gets his hands on the ball. That's excellent play, isn't
Skipper.
It, Martin?
Skipper.
Brilliant play. And I think it was great work from Scott Williams as well, because like you say, Scotland had the overlap, but Scotland shot out of the line, just spooked. I think it was Fraser Brown who tucked, went into the contact, and that's, you know, meet and drink the Warburton and Tipperick.
One penalty, one conversion to his name. Lee Halfpenny, this a second penalty attempt. Turned immediately, Lee Halfpenny liked it, likes what's on the scoreboard. Scotland 3, Scotland 6, Wales 13. Beautifully taken by Tommy Boyd. Wales were building some sort of wall in front of him, and Boyd just ignored them all and caught the ball, and Scotland are on the move. The Gray brothers wait for the passes. It's Johnny first. Russell. Max Dunbar drives up. Quicker ball for Scotland, and John Barkley. He can't get very far. Russell, Johnny Gray, and brilliant tackle by Alan Wynne-Jones and by Sam Warburton. And Wales have the put in. Oh, the tackling is just spectacular.
Oh, that's incredible. So often Johnny Gray runs really hard. It's a brilliant ball carry. He's been hit by his opposite number now, Wynne-Jones. and he knows that this is a massive collision in the midfield. Tipperick's in there as always, but look at the collision and then the leg drive.
Time off.
It's a drive. Johnny Gray back, you don't often see that. The Welsh defence so far, Martin, has been absolutely outstanding. The only space Scotland have found is on the outside edge. If you try and go through the middle, it's formidable, isn't it?
It really is, and I think, you know, the back five, so physical. Alan Wynne, he's lost the line out, the kick off by Tommy Seymour, so he's still hurting from that, and it's a great response. And you're right, Chris, I think the physicality of the moment of the Welsh has just got the edge over the Scottish.
The try set up by the quick thinking of Rhys Webb. The long pass from Scott Williams, Lee Halfpenny with the final delivery to Liam Williams.
Every pass is just perfect, isn't it? That's really what makes that try. You know it. To the purists, they'll be so proud of that try. The Welsh coaches have Alex King, who works in the attack, and this guy will be so proud of the passing. Absolutely. And it had to be, because Stuart Hogg was coming across, but the passing was perfect.
It's a simple game we overcomplicate sometimes, don't we? And he just shows there, you know, no dummy runners. Just brilliant passing, brilliant execution from the Welsh backline.
Apologies to just a Tipperick, it was he who helped in the tackle with Alan Wynne-Jones. Sam Warburton was very quickly on the scene.
Bind.
Come in.
Set. Yes.
Rob Evans against Zander Fagerson on this near side.
Yeah, it's only our third scrum. The first two, there's a penalty to Scotland, a free kick to Wales, so they have been a mess. So thankfully,
okay, let's go.
We haven't had too many this afternoon.
Wait for my bind. Wait for my bind.
Seconds! Crouch! Bind! Set.
Penalty against Zander Fagerson.
Same picture, 1 and 3 feet.
Feet too far back?
Yeah, he's saying they lost their feet, Ferguson and Gordon Reid. And that probably subconsciously for John Lacey as well. He knows Scotland would have really struggled in the opening two games. Like I mentioned earlier, conceded 8 penalties on opposition ball.
1 and 3 feet come behind him, okay? They need to get their feet underneath them.
They're telling me they're just hinging. So.
Their feet are gone.
John Lacey explaining to John Barkley, Scotland's captain. Ken Owens to throw. Justin Tipperick gets it down to Rhys Webb. Flat to Scott Williams. Webb again. This time orthodox, bigger. Liam Williams off his wing into midfield. Penalty to Wales. Scotland can't work. A turnover. Just for once. It's Hugh Jones.
13, not you, skipper.
Giving away the penalty.
So it's Hugh Jones who's penalised. It'll be interesting to see this one again. He never rolled away from the tackle. 6 was okay, so John Barkley was okay. And that man, Hugh Jones, if you make the tackle, you've got to get out of the way. Roll out to the side. A lot of players try and roll the wrong way. They get it picked up. We'll see what happens. There's Jones with the tackle. We'll see how quickly. Yeah, I think that's a good call by John Lacey. He just delays by a second.
It's clever work from Ken Owens as well, the Welsh number two there. He's pinning Hugh Jones in, so he can't move. Barkley would have thought he was all over that ball to win a penalty, but it's smart play from Ken Owens.
And how annoying is it when you've given away a penalty and the opposite scrum half gives you a pat on the head?
Is that it again?
Pleasant fellows on these scrum halves. I think that tackle area at the minute, the first half in particular, is definitely a tick in the box for Wales. You know, Scotland caused France all sorts of trouble. But Wales are definitely winning that area so far.
Wales at the tackle, Scotland at the breakdown. They've turned Wales over on several occasions. For the moment, Lee Halfpenny. Shortly after putting Wales 13-6 ahead. This with half-time beckoning. Oh, pushed it. A wild miss by Lee Halfpenny standards.
Odd man out.
He's lost, is he? Yeah, very unusual to see Lee Halfpenny. Big kick that as well to put Wales two scores in front.
High and long towards Liam Williams. Hogg comes forward and claims it against the chasing Liam Williams. Ali Price digs out again.
Leave him go.
Fraser Brown led that first charge. Finn Russell going aerial again. Dan Bigger had time to catch. George North. Put out a touch. And he... That wasn't the plan. Scotland take it quickly. And it's in the hands of their major running threat, Stuart Hogg. Hogg threads one through. Brilliantly taken. Tommy Boyd. Hugh Jones. George North back. Couldn't make the tackle. Scotland flood the breakdown, but it's been slowed and it's been turned over by Wales. And Rhys Webb points downfield. He will take the kick. He has Jonathan Davis behind him. This is like the last minute against England. It's going to be Jonathan Davis again. And he does find touch this week.
I thought they would have to do two phases before they cleared, but I tell you what, that time the coaches would be delighted to get the ball in the field. What about this for a counter-attack, Martin? Stuart Hogg so dangerous with the ball in hand, he knows that, the Welsh defenders know that. As they sit off, he just drops it onto the toe. Beautiful kick for Tommy Seymour to get the end of. And then from here, well, I thought Hugh Jones would have made it, but it's Tipperick again with a tackle.
It's not just Tipperick, look how many Welshmen are getting there, you know, compared to blue shirts, but it's absolutely sensational play from Stuart Hogg.
Stuart Hogg, whose kick made the chance possible. All they have for the moment is a line-out. Up they go through Ryan Wilson. Driving hard into midfield. Justin Tipperick involved in the tackle area again. Trying to make...
Stay, skipper.
Keep it as a maul, but it's a ruck. And now it's Scotland again on the move. Richie Gray.
Advantage.
Penalty advantage. Ali Price. No, he's not. Russell, Hugh Jones, Alex Dunbar, crunching tackle by Liam Williams.
By Red, is that what you said?
Still I'll penalty advantage to penalty Scotland. Advantage Johnny Gray. Ryan Wilson, Sam Warburton with the tackle. No advantage.
Six is on back. Eight not rolling.
Sam Warburton penalised.
Eight not rolling.
Well, it's been another cracking 40 minutes of rugby, hasn't it? You see Sam Warburton there. He made the final tackle. I think it was Ross Moriarty who was penalised for not rolling away. But Scotland coming alive towards the end of the first half, applying pressure and an important point to score. Important time to score a point.
Yeah, superb. Last 20 minutes, this game has come to life, hasn't it? And I think it's one of those areas, if you're a Welsh player, if you're a Welsh supporter, you don't mind giving away the 3 points here rather than the try. You're under pressure. Looks like you're going to go into the shed half-time, 4 points in front. So fantastic first half of rugby.
Well, the fortunes have swayed in this opening half. Scotland were facing a Lee Halfpenny penalty. It could have been 6-16. And at half-time now, it could be 9-13. It is exactly that. Finn Russell with the penalty. Half-time whistle goes. Murrayfield at half-time. Scotland 9, Wales 13.
Well, it's a dish that's still kind of on simmer, you think, but it's about to boil. That's the solitary try of the first half from Liam Williams. But as Eddie was saying in the last few moments of that half, Wales could have been 10 points to the good if that Halfpenny penalty had gone over. But as it is, the margin is now just 4 points, as you see a great aerial view of Murrayfield. And there's the facts and figures for you. Wales have had to make a lot more tackles than Scotland, and actually the Welsh defence has been immense, really. The number of genuine try-scoring opportunities that Scotland have had has been very few in that first half. Turnovers is a big issue as well, and we'll talk about that in a positive sense from Scotland's perspective, less so from Wales. What do you think?
I think Scotland only really played in that last 5 minutes of the half. They were getting dominated physically, not the same way that France did 2 weeks ago. It was in the tackle, it was in the contact. Warburton, Tipperick, Bigger, they've all been really, really powerful. But that you saw in that last play, John, or you know, when they almost got the try for Hugh Jones, that's what Scotland needs to do. They need to try and do more of a break the game down. It came from a quick line-out, and that's what they need to do.
And from a Welsh perspective?
Yeah, I think good defence, one opportunity, if they've taken it. I thought the Welsh back row have been immense, especially Sam Warburton. But it's, I think that Scotland have dominated possession and territory, but the Welsh defence at the moment is kind of dictating the game.
Keith?
Yeah, it seemed strangely conservative from both sides for about 30 minutes of it. The only guy that wasn't was Rhys Webb for an awful lot of it. But then in the last 10 minutes, it started to spark. There's a bit more attack. Whether they're worried about the weather and the wind, they haven't been trying too much.
Rhys Webb has been the dominant figure in that first 40 minutes. Yes. He's a real irritant from a Scottish perspective, but for Wales, he's driven everything.
Yeah, this is, the first break. Just watch, he has a sniping run. He spots a prop forward. There he goes, Reid. He's got to stay there. Prop goes early and he's away. And as we picked up before the game, the speed of the ruck in the 22 area. Just watch, he goes in. They don't clear out. A prop forward goes to get the ball. And it's so slow. Look at the Scottish defensive line. And that's been the Achilles heel of Wales. But that was just a glimpse of what Rhys Webb can do. And here's the try. Again, the Scottish scrum. Quick tap right. And they're away. The Scottish defence at sixes and sevens. We'll show it from another angle. It's a good finish. Hogg had no chance. If you show it from a different angle, Rhys Webb takes it. Finn Russell goes in. No, they're short, OK? They've got to drift out. But unfortunately, for Tommy Seymour, there's two runners behind Webb, so is he going to pop it on the shoulder? So he's held his run, and that's made it a two-on-one. So it's a very good finish, but a quick thinking again by Rhys Webb.
And in fact, actually, Rhys Webb was the instigator of what might have been a second Welsh try, which we're going to see in just a second, but he got pulled back for a little bit of foul play.
Yeah, I mean, that was a great try because everyone was having to go back in the angle. And the final pass to Lee Halfpenny caught it. But this is the one you're just referring to here. It's from the line out here. Alwyn Jones, who's been everywhere. But watch Ali Price getting taken out by Tipperick, which creates a bit of space. Then it's all about Rhys Webb. He just pulls back Tommy Seymour there. It's the right call. It's a small amount, but it's just enough to pull it back. And although it went down the other end, it was almost a try. Rightly, it was pulled back.
I'm sure during the course of this half-time and over the course of the next weekend, we're going to be talking about the players who will or won't be on the plane to New Zealand. But as we see the closing elements of that passage of play, Stuart Hogg, when he gets the ball, he's surely, Keith, one of the players who is inked in to be on the plane, if not in the starting position.
Well, I think so. And when you look at some of the kicking that was happening at the start of the game, he wasn't getting into the game at all. And then a quick line out, he's running back. You see Hugh going back in there just to try and make certain a good dummy line in on the inside. But a gorgeous little chink along the ground. He just doesn't have the gas to get all the way, does he, Jiffy?
He didn't, but you know, there is no substitute for pace. You can see that they stand off. Well, just watch him here. They stand off him. He can drift, but once they see, look, there he is. He spots Tipperick. Then Jonathan Davis stands off. There's a 2-on-2 there, so they don't need him. But it's a great decision. Great cover by George North, but you know, brilliant play by Scotland. That's what they've got to do.
Exactly. Start from the quick line, which they need to do. But that skill from Stuart Hogg running at full pace to just drop on his right foot and have the pace and just for it to bounce up perfectly. That's a skill they'll practice. It was beautiful.
It was fantastic. Now, we're going to talk about turnovers now. For the uninitiated watching, when the ball is turned over, how much of that is good play by the person who does the turning over and how much of it is bad play by the person who is turned over?
To the standard that's happening at the moment, it's all about good play, not bad play. Good body position by Bigger goes in onto the ground. It's sloppy, tidy up afterwards. That's just a bit of a mess. That's a loose turnover that isn't forced by any player. You see ball going in here, going in a little bit too high. That's a bit messy. That's a cracking, like Gordon Reid, straight in over the top. Great technique from him. The key guy for an awful lot of these, I mean, these are from the Scottish perspective, but this is trying to force the ball, popping it in out the top. They're not the turnovers we're talking about as such. That's just sloppy play for the most part.
Yeah, I think Scotland are winning that part of the game. But what Wales are doing is the physicality. You can see what Rhys Webb's trying to do there. They want to get the ball offloading. It's a fine line you've got to tread when you're doing that. But they've, I think Wales have won the contact in many ways because it's been silly penalties that are given away.
I think they've won the collision, John. If you look at Scott Williams and Jonathan Davies, they won the collision. So it's that extra yard, the momentum, they get them on the front foot. So there's nothing in this game, really. As I said, it's possession territory. But for me, as Keith explained, we did mention the Welsh back row could be significant, and so far they have.
And let's face it, Sam Warburton is almost not being talked about in terms of a potential Lions captain this summer, but surely he's in the reckoning.
Well, he's given a captain's performance today. He's been stuck in the midst of absolutely everything. And this is what we were talking about earlier on, this technical efficiency to go in without resting your arms on the ground. This Tipperick, which is a great cover tackle, straight back onto his feet. Warburton in beside him and Ross Moriarty piling in afterwards, immediately in, over the ball, technical ability to do the right thing at the right time. That's unbelievably hard on the upper body, and you can't rest your hands on the ground, and that's what I think Warburton is one of the best in the games at.
It's his pace and his decision making. He doesn't go in everyone, he picks and chooses. We always think decision making's for the standoffs. His decision making is brilliant, but when he's got a chance and when he doesn't.
And one of the interesting subplots today is the Gray brothers on one side against Alan Wynne-Jones on the other for a place on the Lions tour. And Alan Wynne-Jones is being spoken about in many places as being a potential Lions captain. Who's winning that at the moment?
I think Alan Wynne is there. I think he's on the plane at the moment, and because I think he's just an all-round player. He's always leads from the front. He's always having a great performance. Technically, he's gifted. So for me, you know, everyone says a bit biased, but it's the second row. We discussed it in the half. The second row choice is so difficult.
The two Gray brothers do a huge amount of work, but Alan Wynne does a huge amount of work that leads to turnovers, that leads to Wales playing better.
We showed, there was the one of the VTs there showed Johnny Gray carrying it in, and Alan Wynne knocked him back with Tipperick, and Richie Gray was 1 yard too short for being there. That's probably summed up the half. Wales have just been that bit more together, knocking them back.
On that though, John, you know, you're talking about these second rows, you forgot England and Ireland. England have got four world-class second rows, so what a fight that's going to be on the plane of second row.
OK, well, it's fascinatingly poised here. Second half coming up very shortly. Last night, Scotland's women beat Wales' women by the narrowest of margins, and you can see that tomorrow night. So highlights tomorrow night at 23:25, you can see there, and it's repeated on Monday. Five Live's weekly podcast is available with Hugo Monier and Chris Jones on Monday, and we have Six Nations highlights in rugby special tomorrow night at 6 o'clock on BBC Two. And we have a Red Button Forum following this programme at about 4:30 this afternoon. Now, I suspect the one person that you don't want to be this weekend is the Italy coach, Conor O'Shea. You'd much rather be Eddie Jones, who's obviously eyeing win number 17 in a row for England against Italy tomorrow at Twickenham. He's overflowing with options. He's got competition for places wherever you look. But as one of his predecessors in the England job repeatedly used to say, coaching is 95% selection.
Well, Eddie, you've shuffled your hand, made a few changes. What's prompted you to mix things up?
Well, every week we're looking to improve the team, and this game's an opportunity again for us to look at different ways we can improve the team. So Ben Teo at 13 allows us to see if he can be a realistic third option for us. We've got John Joseph, we've got Elliot Daly. We know they can play at a high level at 13, so this game's a great opportunity for us to do it.
Plenty thought you'd actually make more changes, so why only four?
Well, plenty thought, plenty. I don't think for the plenty. You know, we go through a process, we look at the players we have available, we look at the opposition, we look at how fit our players are, how emotionally right they are to play, and then we work out what is the best 23 for that week, and they're the number of changes we've made for this week.
You've kept faith with Dylan Hartley despite his early exit against Wales. Why have you done that?
Well, there's no reason not to have Dylan as hooker and captain. Just because he left the field early doesn't mean he wasn't doing the job we wanted him to do, it meant that we wanted Jamie George on and to play the appropriate amount of time we needed him to play. So between those two players, we want a great 80 minutes.
And do you think so far Dylan Hartley is showing no signs of allowing the captaincy to impinge on his performance as a player?
Well, I think he's still very much in his apprenticeship as captain. So I think there's going to be a few more tests for Dylan, and I think he's going to get better and better.
How much is Owen Farrell rapidly turning into the first name on your team sheet? He wins his 50th cap.
Look, he's always been one of the guys we've looked to pick first because he's our goal kicker, he's our defence leader. He's one of the heartbeats of the team. He's an important player, Owen. And the one thing I guarantee you, his next 50 tests will be better than his first 50.
What, you're not tempted by a midfield of, say, Farrell, Teo and Daly? That would have been an option, would it not?
That's a great option. And if you're a coach, you can pick that, Sonia. So next time you're a coach, I'll write in the paper, let's pick that combination.
Big money for Sonia's first match in charge of the England rugby team. I tell you, tomorrow's about the margin, isn't it? Do you fear for Italy tomorrow?
Yes. I think England, the way they started against Wales, they were so powerful. You know, they were clinical. The passing was of a high standard. I think it could be a record score tomorrow.
Well, I mean, they've conceded 96 points so far, John, Italy, and you go to Twickenham on a Sunday. You know, the debate about Georgia is only going to get stronger if there's more scores like that.
Well, if it is a big margin tomorrow, I'm sure that'll be one of the talking points for us in Rugby Special tomorrow night. And Keith, a quick word about the match in Dublin this afternoon. That's going to be a very physical match.
Very physical. It's all about Johnny Sexton being back and how much attention he gets at the hands of the French back row and midfield. Very, very tough, and hoping for a very narrow Irish victory.
OK, well, let's get some more Scottish views on today. Let's go down to Lee McKenzie.
Well, Jason White, who and what has stood out for you so far in the first half?
As the guy said in the studio, Justin Tipperick at the breakdown has just been all over the ball. He's like a bad rash who we just can't get rid of. The breakdown work that the Wales team has given Reece Webb the opportunity just to snipe around the breakdown, and we need to make sure from a Scottish point of view the guards get in place quickly.
Things were getting a little fractious towards the end, and in fact this is something which continued as the players went down the tunnel. We saw Richie Gray getting involved and a little bit of sparks flying between him and the Welsh players. This isn't something that you particularly mind, is it?
No, I think it's, as long as it's controlled and it doesn't overstep the mark, it just shows that Richie and the rest of the Scottish team are bang on and they're up for this. And we just need to play on that line of playing right up to the edge and not going over it.
I know you were desperately keen to see the Scottish backs with ball in hand. We saw what Wales could do when the backs got the ball. What that break towards the end, that pleased you very much.
Yeah, that's
it?
What we need to see. We need to see Stuart Hogg with the ball. We've not talked too much about Hugh Jones and Alex Dunbar. We need to get them in the game, get on the front foot, and that's the mixture of the front five and the forwards doing well and the back row winning the ball. And you've seen Stuart Hogg today. He's on fire. He gets the crowd involved, and we need to see more of him.
Thanks very much, Jason.
Scotland at home against Wales. Finn Russell starts Scotland's first penalty, and it's over. We're all square at Murrayfield. Free kick quickly taken. Chance for Wales, and Liam Williams, first try of the game. John Hardy will play no further part in the game. Scotland celebrates. Lee Halfpenny liked it. Fantastic first half for rugby. Scotland 9, Wales 13.
So it's poised on a knife edge, and as ever, we're going to talk about the benches, the guys who are going to come off and maybe make the difference, the finishers. Jonathan, surely the power here is with Wales.
It is, but like I said, you know, against England, I think the bench should have come on. That would have made a better impact on the players that came on off the bench. So hopefully, you know, the position there to bring someone like Sam Davis on, obviously Faletau and Gareth Davies, but I think it's a timing. If Webb is controlling it at the moment, so if he keeps on doing that, he stays on, and let's see what happens now next second half.
Well, Wales have been out for quite a while actually, and Scotland have kept them waiting. Maybe there were a few things that had to be said by Vern Cotter in the dressing room, which would have been
play like the last 5 minutes of the first half, not the first 35 minutes. And Scotland do that and get that fast game, get Hawk, Hugh Jones, Seymour running in space, and they've got a chance. If they allow Wales to continue to dominate the tackle, then Wales win this.
Well, we've had some really, really enthralling duels over the first two weekends, and they've been really, really tight going into the last 10 minutes or so. You suspect this match is going the same way. Let's go back to our commentary team led by Eddie Butler.
No changes apart from Hamish Watson for John Hardy. That was made in the early in the first half. John Barkley, Scotland's captain. Tommy Seymour on the wing. Tommy Boyd. Well taken by Stuart Hogg. Wales tried to hold him up. Hogg out to Xander Fagerson, the prop. Ali Price, the scrum half. Johnny Gray. Price waits again. Rob Evans trying to make a nuisance of himself. Halfpenny waits. And drops. Gone backwards. Didn't go backwards. So, Lee Halfpenny. Well, you don't see that very often.
No, that is the channel in this pitch here in Edinburgh. The wind really swirls in there. I think he caught it, he dropped it, and he almost got it back. But that won't bother Lee Halfpenny. He'll put that out of his mind and get on with the job in hand. It did go forward before putting back, but it's the same tactic. Every kick today has been contestable. We've not seen long kicks. They've been contestable. That one was probably too long, but Scotland got lucky as Lee Halfpenny couldn't quite handle it.
The big question is, are we eventually going to see a scrum completed? Because they have been a total mess so far in the first half.
Sam Warburton's head bobs up just to have a look at what the Scottish three quarters are all about. Ross Moriarty, two at number eight. Rob Evans, number one, expresses his frustration.
Just have two of you come here. Come here. Don't need anybody else. Don't need anybody else. No. Your feet are two back and you're pulling down. That's it. The two of you sort those two problems out, or the two of you will leave. Are we clear? Let's do what I say, please.
Well, it's pretty clear, isn't it? But this is where John Lacey needs Matt Carley on the far side, his assistant referee, to really help him. He can't see both sides, but he's so close to Carley. They should be communicating and finding out what exactly is happening on that far side.
Bind.
Scotland scrum holds well. Out it comes. The scrum is completed. Tommy Seymour off his wing. Slowed up. Ali Price has to wait again. Stuart Hogg. Justin Tipperick tries to hold him up, and again, Hogg gets the ground. Richie Gray.
Hold.
Orbiton hold over the ball.
No, stay.
Can't win it this time.
Tackle!
Finn Russell. No way through there. But he does well, the fly half, to twist and turn. Price goes on a run. Jonathan Davis ordered back.
Use it!
Alex Dunbar plays scrum half. And again, over the ball. Hamish Watson plays scrum half. It comes out to John Barkley. And again, the Greys find no way through. Russell to Hogg. It's going to be Tommy Seymour, or is it?
Well, if Scott Williams has made that tackle, that's an unbelievable tackle.
It's just whether he's touching goal rather
than touching. Rowan, try yes or no, please.
Rowan Kitt will review the effort.
Scott Williams comes across. Looks like a try for Tommy Seymour. An incredible effort by Scott Williams, but it looks like Tommy Seymour's grounded the ball.
Yes.
Try awarded by John Lacey. Tommy Seymour the scorer. It's a flying start by Scotland. There is a price to pay. Tommy Seymour still receiving attention.
Yeah, it looks like he's winded, but again, the space is on the outside edge, isn't it? Finn Russell carries the ball to the line, and Stuart Hogg, who again just delays his pass to Tim Visser, and Tim Visser does really well to draw in Lee Halfpenny and release Seymour, who just gets the ball down, despite the efforts of Scott Williams.
Yeah, it's a great finish by Seymour, but it's great build-up play. Liam Williams has just bitten on the decoy runner. And a great finish from the two wingers, Visser and Seymour.
Russell from wide out. Off the post, over. 7 points for Scotland. They take the lead at Murrayfield. Scotland 16, Wales 13.
Yeah, if you see Liam Williams here, he just bites on Hugh Jones just that little bit. Allows Visser to come around on the outside. A wonderful finish from Seymour.
Hamish Watson underneath it, under pressure from George North. Russell comes away with it. And that's a fine clearance under pressure by Finn Russell.
It's another good exit from Scotland. A little bit scruffy at the kickoff, but Finn Russell managed to get his boot to ball, and you can see the effect of the wind from a narrow angle, taking the ball up to halfway, and a line opportunity for Wales.
Wales take their time at the line-out. Alan Jones, it's an overthrow. John Barkley comes away with it. Alex Dunbar couldn't pass. Jonathan Davis had cut out his option. Price to Ferguson. The crowd in full voice. Scotland in the lead. Wales still making thunderous tackles, pushing Scotland back into their half. Johnny Gray. Russell will put it high. That's brilliantly taken by Tim Visser. Johnny Gray to Ferguson again. Ferguson involved again. Richie Gray.
Yeah, he's fine.
And again, Ferguson.
Rock!
Russell, high again. Superb catch. A flat back by Tommy Seymour. Russell, all Scotland at the moment. Hamish Watson makes yards and doesn't make yards. Suddenly, the Scottish attacks stop.
Well, it stops and is brought to an end by Alan Wynne-Jones with a tackle, and then he wins a turnover. But we'll look at that for second half possession. And they've got the score to prove it early in the second half. That was a great piece of attack by Scotland, making more ground than they did in the first half. But the Welsh defence came out on top in the end with Alan Wynne-Jones.
Yeah, it's a huge penalty from Alan Wynne-Jones, because Scotland at the minute, they're winning all the 50-50s, making all the right decisions. It's a huge penalty just to kill that momentum a little bit for Scotland, which has totally swung their way in the second half. Here he is, Alan Wynne, not just Wolverton Tipper, he gets in there so strong.
Stay there though.
This is Tommy Seymour winning the aerial battle. We've spoken about the contestable kicks, but Scotland got two back there, one from Visser, one from Seymour.
Skill of the day. Ross Moriarty charges into midfield. Wales on the move for the first time in the second half. They have earned themselves a penalty. Rhys Webb looks one way, goes the other. Jonathan Davis. Davis for the line. The pass can't find a hand. Lee Halfpenny's up there. It's gone forward. Oh, Wales so close.
So where is that? Where is that?
One back away.
So fucking get on your feet then.
Fantasy is over, okay?
clean line break.
The break by Jonathan Davis, and it sets Wales off in the second half.
Well, now everybody's just calmed down, have another look at this. It was a penalty advantage. Rhys Webb goes to the left, and Ken Owens playing a first receiver, delayed pass to a brilliant line. Full pace by Jonathan Davis, excellent tackle by Price, and well, that offload to Rhys Webb, that could have been a try, Martin.
Yeah, I think he's got to give this offload. You know, we've seen Rhys Webb, just a little bit more sympathy on that offload off the floor. We've seen five handling errors from Wales. They probably have forced one or two, but I think that time Jonathan Davis was fully justified in trying to find Rhys Webb.
Well, if he didn't, he would have been turned over, wouldn't he? There's two defenders there on top of him.
So clean was the break, that the advantage was over. So instead of having the penalty, Wales end up that close to the line, but with Scotland putting the ball into the scrum.
The game's just so finely balanced, isn't it? Scotland ebbed ahead, you know, in the start of the second half with some good possession, good territory. We just saw a start that was 99% possession for Scotland, and then a flash, a blink of an eye, Jonathan Davis cutting through the Scottish defence.
Yeah, expect Wales to really attack the Scottish scrum here.
I was just about to say, what pressure can Wales exert? You can just see the strain there. I'd be surprised, Martin, if this one goes full term.
I totally agree. It's going to go one way or the other. Xander Ferguson's had a great game in the loose. You know, he's a young, he's a huge prospect for Scotland. Has had his struggles. You know, this is another level up from obviously playing for Glasgow, but interesting to see John Lacey's gone over to the other side of the scrum to watch Rob Evans and Xander Ferguson.
Interesting setup in Scotland as well. Finn Russell, you see on the goal line, quite flat. Usually in this position, if you're going to clear, you want a bit of depth, a bit of time to give yourself a kick to get away. So he's maybe looking to attack the right-hand side.
Ali Price feeds the scrum. It's done well. Quick ball, and away comes Ali Price. Tommy Seymour gives away the penalty, crossing obstruction. It is a penalty for Wales. It's wide out. What's the option here?
Well, if you go in the England game, Alwyn Jones went for the corner. Every time Dan Biggar looks as if he's shaping up to go for the corner as well.
Shot indicated.
Dan Biggar asked the question. Al.
Shot is indicated. Shot is indicated.
No, they've indicated to go a goal, so they can't change their mind. Oh no, he hasn't.
No,
they can.
Boys.
Wales for the corner.
I thought once you'd indicate it's actually once the kicking tee's on as well, isn't it? Jenkins is halfway across the field.
Yeah, and Jenkins is on with the kicking tee, so if anything comes of this, but there's a.
That's the obstruction. Ryan Wilson, I think, just blocking Warburton to make the tackle on Seymour.
Ken Owens finds Sam Warburton. All the drive comes on. Wales obstruct in front of the ball. Penalty to Scotland, and Johnny Gray celebrates. The crowd are relieved.
Yeah, it's an old tactic Wales have used before. Nearly all the backline were in there. Lee Halfpenny, Jonathan Davis. You've got to be so careful when you lift the man that you don't obstruct in front, and John Lacey's picked it up.
Getting there. Gotta keep working on it, though, Skipper, okay?
No shortage of drama in the second half. Alan Dale prepares to come onto the field.
Yeah, you can bring them time off. Time off, please, one blue.
Gordon Reid is coming off.
It's a big passionate figure. Gordon Reid has done well this afternoon. He put so much energy in around the breakdown. You saw his counter-up for the turnover. I think he's done well in the set scrum as well on his side. And then Cotter bringing on Alan Dale, who started the opening two games of the Championship.
Fraser Brown takes his time, finds John Barkley. Ali Price pushes a little tester towards Liam Williams. Lee Halfpenny, Wales counter from deep. Bigger for himself. It's gone backward. John Barkley, great pickup by the captain. Price over Halfpenny's shoulders. Didn't quite get the bounce Price wanted. Halfpenny, will he keep it infield? He does. Stuart Hogg.
Backwards.
It's gone backwards. Finn Russell. Russell chased by Sam Warburton. Warburton down, straight back up.
I got
two.
line.
Ryan Wilson delivers. Johnny Gray. Gets the ground on the halfway line. Price turns, goes the other way. And it's clear! Ali Price! Tackled by Halfpenny. Support from Dell. Ferguson makes the pass. Williams came charging out the line, and it worked because he throws Ryan Wilson to the ground. Wales looking for the turnover. Russell comes away with it. Penalty advantage to Scotland. Barkley. Whoops. Alex Dunbar with the quite the strangest kick we may see this championship.
Yeah, wouldn't be too happy with that one, but having a penalty advantage, I think his boots on the wrong
number
feet.
11.
It's the second half, Alex.
No, it was more good pressure from Scotland there. Ali Price with a break up the middle. He got hit hard from Lee Halfpenny, but he managed to get the ball away to Alan Dale in support. And then from there, Lee Williams, who's as good in defence as he is in attack, managed to get back and then be penalised. But there's Ali Price's break in and around that breakdown again. Alan Dale in support.
He's
a good ball carrier down there, very dynamic for a loose head prop.
Yeah.
And then Scotland win the penalty.
So be sure I'm trying to deal with both sides. Yeah. Sugar.
Finn Russell. This to extend Scotland's lead. They trailed at half-time by 4 points. This to go 6 points into the lead, and they do.
Yeah, it's a big swing, Eddie. Your finger wheels turned on the opportunity for maybe go for 3 points. Went for the line-out, got penalised, and Scotland worked their way down.
A change ordered by Vern Cotter at scrum half. So Ali Price, having made the break, gives way to Henry Purgos. Hamish Watson loses out to George North. Scott Williams. So, from the restart, Wales back in possession. Rob Evans.
Our feet. Yeah, go back now. Go back to the back foot, please.
Rhys Webb with Lee Halfpenny acting outside half. Webb again. Jonathan Davis tries to hand off Hugh Jones. Jones makes the tackle. Moriarty.
Stay there, skipper.
Quickly delivered, Webb. Evans, a little sidestep from the prop, makes ground. Halfpenny, bigger, Justin Tipperick. George North outside him. Tipperick didn't risk the pass. Knock on by Wales. Scotland with the put-in and a mini celebration. Not by Rob Howley, the Wales coach.
Steve Bissell wasn't getting his hands in. Tipperick just losing control of the ball. It's the first mistake he's made today. Been outstanding. That guy in an attack and defence is such a high work rate, hasn't he, Mark?
He's top class. You know, he could easily play in the backs as well. Justin Tipperick, you saw his cover defence early on in the first half. And Hugh Jones, an absolutely superb player. He's got the full package, you know, defensively, offensively. World class open side in my eyes.
The tries, Wales in the first half, Liam Williams, Scotland in the second, Tim Visser 2, Tommy Seymour. A 6 point lead.
I can see him, you know, but. Guys, number four, you said, was it? Red four, please. Skipper, red four.
Jake Ball is going off. And on comes Luke Charteris, one of the highly experienced players coming off the bench for Wales. Cap number 72 for Luke Chartres.
Yeah, he's carried well, Jake Bourne. Different sort of second role, Luke Chartres. He'll cover lots of ground, make a lot of tackles defensively.
Touch! Find!
Change at scrum half, Chris.
Yeah, Henry Pergos is a very experienced campaigner. More similar to Greg Laidlaw than Ali Price, a great head on the shoulders.
It's out, Rhys Webb steals, and Webb is away. Can he finish? Can he finish? It will go to review.
So it's happy, so try yes or no. Yeah, thank you. Ron?
Got you.
We're happy with scrum, try yes or no, please.
Okay, try yes or no.
Yeah, thank you.
Busy day for Rowan Kitt.
Oh, that's a question, is a try, yes or no? This man, Rhys Webb, has been outstanding so far, and look how sharp he is again. If he beats Tim Visser, and what's that, half a metre of space, it's an incredible finish. He's reaching with the ball in his right hand. We're looking at his left foot. It looks like it touches the line just before. But that's an incredible effort, even to get as close as that, man.
Yeah, okay, from the problems from the Scottish scrum as well, very unstable. Quick as a flash, Rhys Webb onto it.
The red player was in touch.
Just in touch.
Line out. Scotland throw. Rhys Webb. So close.
So quick, isn't he? So dynamic. Just a sniff and he's away. And worrying signs for Scotland, I felt, in the scrum. It's the front row that struggled in the first two games. And again, really unstable scrum.
Fraser Brown to throw. Luke Chartres in his first line out. Black scrum cap on the Welsh side. It's gone long. Oh, and it worked. Ryan Wilson comes away with it. Wales read the move, but it still was performed clinically by Scotland. And they clear. They clear well.
You could see that from the Welsh players knew exactly what was coming in. That was a 50-50, black or red. Real gamble, great throw from Fraser Brown, a great take from Ryan Wilson.
Tom Francis, here's the near try for Rhys Webb, foot in touch. Tom Francis is off. There's the offending boot. Wales are underway again. Scott Williams in midfield. Oh, Sam Warburton won the scraps. It's well gone forward, though. Little things going wrong for Wales. Warren Gatland, the Lions coach, watching on.
There's Alex Dunbar. Finn Russell with a tackle, and then Alex Dunbar with a strip, ripping it out. The opposite number, Scott Williams. Alex Dunbar's four turnovers so far in the championship. There's a fifth. He's so powerful in around there, but Scott Williams will be disappointed with that. Take pride when you carry the ball, and be disappointed to lose out.
Scotland made a flying start to the second half, scored their points, and ever since then they've been on defensive duty, but they have this scrum and a chance to go on the attack again.
Score again. Hold your weight, please. On my call.
Samson Lee on the far side of the Welsh front row, wearing 18.
Expect Scotland just a quick strike straight to Ryan Wilson's feet and away from this scrum as quick as possible if they can manage it.
Yeah, let's go again, lads. No stability.
It's all right, so I had to stay there.
Let's go.
Don't let him hinge. Let's go.
Coming up to 60 minutes on the verge of the last quarter. There's been plenty of daring, plenty of adventure, plenty of mishaps so far. And it just seems one of those games where there'll be more to come. Henry Pergos, as seen by John Lacey, Wales managed to get a little drive on. They get a big drive on. Ryan Wilson does well to come away with it to feed Pergos, and Scotland can't get out of their half because Stuart Hogg has kicked straight into touch and says, sorry lads.
Yeah, so Tipperick's probably first and only mistake of the day earlier on, and that's Stuart Hogg's first mistake of the day. He puts his hand up, he acknowledges that, but it's all down to the scrum pressure, isn't it? It's not a clear, stable base to kick from or attack from, and Wales continue to apply the pressure.
OK, move back, please. Two!
Ken Owens came in with a perfect record throwing. Hasn't been quite perfect today, but it's worked well this time. Away comes Moriarty, feeds Warburton. Liam Williams off his wing. Rhys Webb waits. Rhys Webb alert, finds Rob Evans. Great pass by the prop to Luke Charteris. Webb again. Jonathan Davis. Hamish Watson tries to strip. Watson does well to get out of the way, not give away the penalty. Evans again. Moriarty. Scott Williams.
Stay four.
Webb has a little look, feeds Luke Charteris, who knocks on, another knock on. A scrum advantage being played to Scotland. Russell with the clearing kick. Referee says not much of an advantage.
I think you're Scotland, you don't want the scrum. You want the...
I think the referee may be looking at something here, okay. Martin.
Ron, what are we looking at?
Just looking at the actions of red 7.
Red 7?
Lifting blue 10.
Okay, thank you. Just give me the red 7, I don't need you anymore, thank you.
Tipperick on a clean out.
Justin Tipperick. His action on the side of the ruck, Martin, being looked at.
The crowd obviously jeered as they would, but it's whether Tipperick, in his action of cleaning out the Scottish players, lifted the legs above horizontally. You've got to be so careful these days. Obviously caught the corner of John Lacey's eye. There's Tipperick, obviously, with the blue head cap. No, he's got to be careful. This is...
He's certainly lifted and twisted it. Finn Russell, he's not driven at the ground, he's landing his back. I think he is above the horizontal, probably looking at a yellow card.
You've just got to be so careful these days. Once you lift that leg, you know, I think players are starting to buy it a little bit as well, you know, and go with the momentum, but it's, you know, it dicey with danger as soon as you lift that leg.
Just going to give a penalty, just a penalty against Red 7 for lifting.
Just a penalty.
I think because Justin Tipperick almost... knows what he was doing, he tried to save the situation after it started. There was no malice, he never drove him into the field, but the penalty only. We've seen Morgan for that man, but I think Tipperick did try and save the situation.
He realised, didn't he?
Scotland getting some relief. They had a knock-on advantage, Wales spilling the ball again. There's plenty of pressure from Wales, plenty of changes now as Jamie Roberts comes on into midfield. Taurupe Faletau comes on. Scott Williams goes off. Ross Moriarty goes off.
Yeah, another big game for Moriarty. Perhaps not as eye catching as last week, but done a lot of graft. And Scott Williams had a great game in the centre as well, but stacks of experience come off the bench of Jamie Robertson Faletau.
Richie Gray wins the line out.
That's one stop nine.
Scotland edge their way forward. They haven't enjoyed possession for quite a while now. They're on the march now. Wales, though.
One thing you don't try and do when Luke Charteris on the pitch is drive them all, because the man is sensational. He's said before, he's like Inspector Gadget. He gets that big frame over and just kills it straight away.
There he is. Luke Charteris, he's huge. And he uses those arms to go where shorter arms can't.
Time off, please, Graham.
Right, now then, it's very tense. Is it for you, Jason?
Just where we're seeing the game being played in the second half. From where I'm sitting just down here, just in the level on the halfway, Wales are playing all of the game in the Scottish half, and we just need to find a way from the Scottish point of view
How do we get back down that end and bring back into play our big strike player, Stuart Hogg, getting on the ball. The back row in the second row are working their socks off. We just saw the subs just coming on for Wales. Jamie Roberts, Faletau, it's just been a really strong bench to come on for this last 18 or so minutes.
We had that amazing statistic at the start of the second half where Scotland had 99% of territory possession, but that's turned now. Taulupe Faletau, he came on against England. He's been struggling with a knee injury, well, all season really, but he is a magnificent player when he's fit and doing well. Scotland are awarded the penalty at the scrum. And given what happened at the last scrum, Wales will, well, they'll be very disappointed with that.
Disappointed, I think, is putting it there mildly, Eddie. They'll be really frustrated, you know. Total dominance in the last scrum. And John Lacey, well, you can't say at least he's made a decision. You know, we haven't had to go through three or four collapsed scrum, but that's a big decision from John Lacey there when Wales seem to be on top in the scrum.
10 penalties apiece. Scotland in the Welsh half at last. Fraser Brown, not many front row forwards who start make it into the last quarter, but here is Scotland's hooker. And finding John Barkley, his captain.
One stop, no.
There's Luke Charteris again, busy at work in the mall.
Those arms,
he's got hold of Hamish Watson, but Scotland come through the midfield. Russell. Long from Jones to Visser. Visser goes past George North. Can't go past Lee Halfpenny. But Scotland move into the Welsh 22. Richie Gray. Ferguson.
No. Can't just escape.
Hamish Watson feeds Johnny Gray. Gray stops, takes stock of the situation. Tries to set it up. Henry Purvis is told to hurry up.
I think Finn Russell's lining up for a drop goal here.
Finn Russell behind Henry Purvis. For the moment, though, through Hamish Watson, Scotland happy to take it further into Welsh territory. Purvis. John Barkley, the captain. Tipperick joins the tackle. Sam Warburton over the ball. Order to release. Scotland have it. It has been slowed up, though.
Use it.
Fraser Brown, the hooker.
Tackle's fine. And release, Tony.
Still there on the Scottish side. Purvis to John Barkley. Russell, long to Hard, Tim Visser! Scotland break out and the lead grows!
Well, as a crowd celebrate, Tim Visser smiles. That's a crucial score and a crucial time in the match to score. And it's the first time Scotland had territory for a long time in the second half. And it was built through the phases, making ground in almost every carry, and then watch this for a pass from Stuart Hogg. Quick as you can through the hands, pulls in George North, and Tim Visser just hugged that touchline all day. Watch this from the pass, through the hands, and that strike man, Tim Visser, scores again.
Yeah, it's class from the pace of Finn Russell's ball to Hogg. No, just holds the inside man for Wales, then the class of Hogg to put Visser in. Visser started that, actually standing up George North and going on the outside. It looked as if Finn Russell was standing in the pocket to go for the 3 points, but a gap from a snipe from Purvis got him on the front foot, and it's great patience from the Scottish as well. Fully deserved try.
They started the second half with a real bang, then they went into a long period of being stuck in their own 22, but they've broken out and scored again. Finn Russell with the conversion, it's good. Scotland 26, Wales 13.
Having had a look from a different angle, a flat hand pass from Finn Russell to Stuart Hogg. It's almost too quick for the camera. Flips it on to Tim Vissan. Tim Vissan's hugged that left touchline all day. He's managed to get on the side, outside of George North, and he celebrates his comeback with a try.
Changes in the Welsh team. Scott Baldwin at hooker for Ken Owens. Sam Davies is on for Dan Bigger.
Use the nine!
Rebound. Everything is going Scotland's way. Stuart Hogg, the chance. Alex Dunbar, under pressure, gets the ball away.
Wouldn't be the most comfortable of kickers, Chris, would he? Alex Dunbar, by the looks of things.
That was a better strike, wasn't it? That was better than the last one.
It went the right direction.
That's exactly what you want. There's a pressure again coming from Rhys Webb on every kick. Stuart Hogg has a look. Is it on? Is it? It isn't. And then Alex Dunbar manages to get away. Does exactly what he needs to do to get it off the field.
Scott Baldwin finds Alan Wynne-Jones. Sam Davies, the new outside half. George North comes off his wing. Sam Davies inside to Scott Baldwin. Jonathan Davies. Prop, Samson Lee. Nicky Smith is on in the Welsh front row. Davies. The turnover is good, says John Lacey. Yet again, Wales have been turned over and Murrayfield erupts again.
So slow from Wales at the base, gives Sam Davies no option. Fantastic work for Hamish Watson over the ball and wins the steal.
So busy, Hamish Watson, as a carrier, as a tackler, and then in around the breakdown as well. Ryan Wilson giving him a pat on the head. But the score as it is now means Wales have to play, they have to make a risk. As the Royal Highness Princess Anne watches on, next to Rob Flockhart, the Scottish rugby president. The crowd in Murrayfield in full voice as well. He's a turnover. Barclay with a tackle, and Watson, just as you see Tipperick and Warburton doing, well, he can do it as well.
Hamish Watson with the turnover. Fraser Brown's work is done. On comes Ross Ford. Cap number 105 for Ross Ford. And he finds Johnny Gray. Burgos. Liam Williams rises high and feeds Lee Halfpenny. Halfpenny down on one knee, yeah. Gets away with it, comes away with it. Back to Rhys Webb now. Sam Davies, Jonathan Davies.
Onside, stay by foot.
Scott Baldwin. Luke Charteris outside him. Wales have to play, have to risk the passes now. That one doesn't go to hand, but Liam Williams comes away with it. Scotland with the penalty, another obstruction. John Barclay.
Yeah, it's a hard one to take for Liam Williams, who, yet again, has been outstanding in that red jersey. He's trying so hard to pick up the loose ball, he's trying to take on two or three Scotland defenders and then runs into his own man. A big decision here for Scotland. I think we'll go into the corner, but I'm wrong.
No, points. 13 points ahead there, Sam Davies.
It's just Davies, and you can understand what Sam Davies is trying to do. They're trying to get back into the game, trying to keep the ball in play. Liam Williams has to pick up the loose ball, but Tipperick is just in the wrong place at the wrong time as a tackle comes in from Ryan Wilson.
I think the option to go for goal, it eats up the clock as well, doesn't it?
I think it's the right decision, you know, when you go back to Wales' opportunity, 19-13, I can't remember what the score was, where Alan Wynne's decided to go to the corner instead of going for the points, and you have to question that, you know, when you've got a goal kicker like Lee Halfpenny in your ranks.
Curled it in. Superb kick. Not only is the clock run down, the scoreboard has gone up. Scotland 29, Wales 13.
Yeah, it's a brilliant kick, the smile to prove it as well. So hard in that east stand touch, and he's talked about how blasted the wind is, and he's nailed that right down the middle.
Johnny Gray comes away with the ball. Finn Russell.
Away now, nine.
Ross Ford, the new hooker, he loses out though. Justin Tipperick, long to the captain, Alan Wynne-Jones. Scott Baldwin to Jonathan Davis. Samson Lee. Nicky Smith in support, wearing 17. Alex Dunbar fighting for possession. Down on the ground, wearing 12 for Scotland. Luke Charteris. Rhys Webb to Davis. Halfpenny. Jamie Roberts tries the quick pass, intercepted, and again, George North this time. Tim Visser with the one, North with another.
Followed by...
Nicky Smith plays scrum half. Scott Baldwin, short to Faletau. Tipperick, long, bouncing to Sam Davis. Davis. Thought he saw a little gap. It closed.
Ball's available, he can play.
Nicky Smith.
Wilson.
Webb. In time honoured fashion, Jimmy Roberts crashes it up. Webb.
Nine. Liverpool five.
On the 22. Oh, Tipperick to Samson Lee. Tipperick again. Smith. Faletau. Scotland's defence. Solid. Good enough to win a penalty. And that says it all.
It's Hamish Watson again. It is. Came onto the field after about 20 minutes for an injury to John Hardy. Started the two games, the first two games in the championship, and he's been outstanding again. You can see the penalties, 23 penalties, 13 conceded from Wales. Coaching staff won't be happy with that. You want to try and keep it undermined, but is that man Hamish Watson winning that penalty again?
Doubts over Finn Russell's place kicking? Well, they've been answered today, and it's been one of those afternoons, a thoroughly enjoyable afternoon if you're wearing blue.
I think they've been outstanding, Scotland, in the second half, haven't they, in particular? I think half-time going in Wales seemed to have all the momentum. Physically, they were dominating Scotland, but they've been very clinical, Scotland. One chance, put Visser over, and they haven't looked back. The Wales have got... On the flip side, they've gone really sloppy in the back end, last 20 minutes since the replacements.
And Scotland have kept Wales pointless in this second half. Not much wind. And Scotland in not much of a hurry to get to the line out. 4.5 minutes to go. John Barkley has been a real presence in the line-out.
One stop, Sanders.
Fergus has to go in digging for the ball. Scotland can think of winding the game down.
Six away now.
Richie Gray. Johnny Gray. Here's one of the star performers, Hamish Watson.
Tackle!
Russell again. Liam Williams went for the interception. It's just a knock-on. but it will be a Scotland put in, and the clock runs.
Just the knock on.
I know. Tommy Seymour, try scorer. Right, the moment has come. Who is the man of the match?
Well, there's been a few candidates, Sam Morton, Justin Timberlake in the back row, as always, for Wales. Rhys Webb's had a massive game. Hamish Watson has made a huge impact off the bench. The Grady brothers in the second row, Ryan Wilson as well, but all these candidates. But the man in the picture has been our RBS man in the match, Finn Russell. 7 from 7 for all the grunt, for all the determination in the Scottish team, the needle head around the field, and under pressure, Finn Russell has delivered an outstanding match from the Scotland number 10.
Murrayfield is buzzing. Murrayfield is about to celebrate Scotland's second victory of the Six Nations. They beat Ireland here. And very shortly, they will have beaten Wales. John Barkley, outstanding as the leader. Henry Purgos has to use it. He won't be going far. Finn Russell, man of the match, tackled by Sam Davis. Wales have a chance. They have 1.5 minutes.
Yeah, that's fine.
Warren Gatland, Lions coach, sort of Wales's coach on sabbatical. It's a difficult day. Unless you're looking for players to fill the Lions slots.
Yeah, I think a result like this really does throw up selection in the air. You know, you mentioned somebody like John Barkley, who nobody really mentions when it comes to Lions selection, but he's been absolutely outstanding today. Hamish Watson, you know, all the flankers in fairness, you know, whether they're in a red jersey or blue jersey, have been outstanding. But somebody like Finn Russell as well, you know, he stuck his hand up again. It's really interesting, you know, with the Lions hand on. But full credit to Scotland, they really deserve this. Really composed second half. They came under pressure, but they withstood that, and they've gone at the other end and been incredibly clinical.
Scored at important times, didn't they? That penalty just before half-time to make it 13-9, and then the try after 43 minutes early in the second half. Important time in the game to score.
Wales have stopped scoring. 15 against England, 13 today. Jonathan Davis comes away with it. It's way below their average over the past few seasons in the Six Nations. They have a chance to improve their average. They're not going to win the game, but here they come looking for a second try. Webb to Liam Williams. Scotland over the ball again. Win yet another penalty. We're into overtime. Scotland sink to their knees. But they won't be down there for long. It's been a wonderful day of rugby at the home of the game in Scotland. Smiles all round, one boot into touch and the job is done. John Lacey blows his whistle. Scotland, 2 out of 3, still in the hunt. Vern Cotter, happy man, heads down to greet his players. Scotland have comprehensively beaten Wales by 29 points to 13.
What a performance from Scotland. It was met with a lot of physicality from Wales, but John Barkley leading for the first time as captain led his side so fantastically. Another physical game, 2 tries to 1 for Scotland, and a terrific performance.
Yeah, all credit to Scotland. You think of the players who were missing as well, the injuries. A lot of people thinking that would be the difference today with the guys coming in.